How we doing, Majestic? Good to see you this morning. Yes, it's us again.
We're back.
New surroundings, new venue. How good is it to be in here?
This is just so awesome. This is our first service in our new venue. And of course, we didn't ever think it was just going to be with 10 people, which is all we can do here now. We thought it was going to be, hundreds of people. So,
yeah.
But hey, it's a start, isn't it?
It's a start, and we're here.
Great to be in the venue.
It feels pretty good, right?
Yeah, it feels awesome.
And I mean, all that to say, we've actually been here all weekend.
Yep.
We've had ModeCon, Mode Conversations 2020, and we just finished that yesterday morning, and we had a great weekend doing that together.
Was awesome.
It's kind of interesting that was the kind of the first thing that actually took place in the building. Which is, kind of interesting, being that it is our creative conference. And we had some great creative conversations with some of our incredible team from Majestic, the Mode team. And also we had special guests come in from around the world. And so if you were a part of that or happened to catch some of that, thanks for tuning in and being a part of the weekend. But we're excited to be here on our first Sunday in the building.
Absolutely.
So welcome. Welcome to you all. Yeah. If you're just tuning in, here we are. Yes, the surroundings look different today. We're not sitting on the lounge, but we're sitting in our new facility. So welcome to Majestic.
It's like a big extended lounge, really, isn't
That's it?
This foyer area.
Still kind of loungy.
Right. It is quite loungy-ish.
Yep.
Yeah, it's got the carpet on the floor.
Yeah, we got a little rug action, little neon in the back.
Yep. So, welcome to those who are tuning in for the first time, because, you're not up to date on Facebook or stuff like that. I'm just thinking of one person in particular, but I won't bag them out this morning. But
probably many people.
Plus other this morning, this is your first opportunity to tune back into our services at Majestic. Hey, welcome back in. It's great to have you with us.
Great to have you with us.
Yeah,
that's
really
it.
Good.
And hopefully you got on easily enough this morning. As time goes on, we'll get better at this too. And this time really has forced us into the live stream world, which the crew's done an incredible job setting up
Amazing.
In a short amount of time to get us going, to get us here, so we could have that for ModeCon, as well as start doing our Sundays. And because of now level two, we're able to be here in our premises, in our church facility. And so we're excited about that and the opportunities that creates as well, right?
Absolutely.
In the weeks to come. So look out, we're here. And we're moving forward, and we're getting closer, ladies and gentlemen, closer to something. And who would have thought we would have been here, right?
Yeah,
we thought we would have been here,
but
being here in a different kind of capacity, numbers, and we would have been weeks into being in this property, being in this facility. But here we still are. And how's your week been? How's things been for you? Level two, what day are we now? Is it day two? Three, four?
I've stopped counting.
Yeah, I've lost count. It's around there somewhere. It's early. It's early days.
It's early days.
But we're here, and so hope you guys are doing well. Hope you guys are staying positive. Hope you guys are treating each other well, and also, tuning in and making the most of this time that we have here together. And so set yourself up wherever you find yourself this morning, in your bedroom. You might not have even got out of bed yet. Who knows? In the lounge with the family around the table. We're so grateful to you for tuning in with us. And so if you're in Christchurch tuning in, part of Majestic or part of Majestic around the world or wherever you might be tuning in from, we're so happy that you're with us here today, this morning.
Yeah, great.
Yeah.
Right.
Shall we? I don't know. Shall we? I guess.
Yeah.
I guess that's what we're here to do. If you are still tuning in, welcome to Majestic. Once again, so glad to have you here with us this morning.
Yeah.
And we're going to be speaking off the back of our Mode conversations that we had, which, of course, centered around creativity, Creator God. And so we had some incredible conversations over the weekend about that. And today we just kind of want to launch off that into, we had a little catchphrase.
Yeah,
we had a couple, really. And one being that we should be producers, not just consumers of creativity. And that's something that we want to keep encouraging us in, that we wouldn't just consume, but we would produce, and as creative beings that we would practice that and allow great production to come out of our lives, because what we put into the world can make the world a better place.
Right.
But the thing, once the whole Mode thing shifted and we knew we weren't going to be able to do what we had originally planned to do, it became something else. And so we're thinking about this idea, it's something else. And so this morning we just want to take a little bit of time just to kind of speak into this, sort of give it some framework this morning. And you can have more conversations about it during the week today, and we might even continue to talk into it a bit later on as time goes on. So
Yeah, because there's different ways, right, you can look at that phrase too. Yeah, you go, oh man, this is just something else. I mean, there is something else that's going on, because we couldn't do what we were going to do before.
Yeah.
So the whole it's something else thing, I think unpacking that this morning with some framework about where we're wanting to go with it today is really important. Because you know, something it could be a negative term.
Or
it can be a real positive term.
Yeah.
Man, it's something else. But man, it's something else is what we're wanting to get across this morning. That even though things have shifted and changed for us over this time, man, there's still something else that God's got for us, right?
And so,
so that's what we want to really.
And I guess again, that word perspective comes into that, right?
Yep.
Because it's how you see, whether we like it or not, we are in something else.
We are.
That's undeniable, right? Yep. But it's our perspective on that something else, like Dad was just saying, whether it becomes a positive thing or a negative thing. Yep. And we want to jump into a story at some point this morning, probably soon, that kind of highlights that real clear. So
We could probably jump.
Shall
we go there now?
Let's
go there now. Yeah, God, because we've been talking a lot about the fact that these are days of opportunity for us as people and as the church. And what are those opportunities? And I think we're still trying to land with what those things might be.
Oh,
but little things along the way help us. And I think it's starting with who we are as people and what does God want to do in and through our lives that actually going to help bring some fresh creativity out of that and through this whole thing. Man, it's something else. There's something else that we can be. There's something else that we can do.
Yeah.
There is something else that God has got for us. And I was thinking about that story of the spies that were sent into the promised land to go and suss it out.
Right.
And so from Numbers chapter 13 and 14, you can find that story. If you want to read the whole story, we just want to pick out a few scriptures and points out of that today. The thing with that story is that they didn't quite know what they were in for.
Yeah.
And so the whole thing actually sending some guys in there to have a look was to actually, so the people would have some confidence in what the report was that they would bring back.
Right.
But it's interesting how the story goes.
Yeah.
Because 12 leaders of the tribes are picked to go in to the land and to suss out the land and come back with some kind of report.
Yeah.
And verse 21 says to us, so they went up and explored the land from the wilderness of Zin as far as Rehob, Lebo Hamath. There's some great words there.
Mm-hmm.
And then going north, they passed through the Negev, arrived at Hebron. And there you've got all those descendants of Anak were there. And the ancient
who were like giants,
Hebron,
right?
Yeah, like giants.
Yeah.
The ancient town of Hebron was founded 7 years and all of that. And they came to the valley of Eshcol, and they cut down a branch with a single cluster of grapes so large that it took two of them to carry it on a pole between them. And they also brought back samples of the pomegranates and figs. So they already knew it was meant to be a land of plenty, right?
Yeah.
It was
place
was bountiful.
Yes. They knew that, right?
They
knew that they were going into the promised land. So they had, that was the title that it was given. But still, I guess they wanted to send people in just to go check it out.
Check it out.
Yeah.
Yep. Exactly.
Which I guess is not a bad thing, right?
No.
You know, so, you know, even in thinking about that, it's like that wasn't necessarily a negative thing just to go suss things out. How will we do this?
Yeah.
It's probably, you know, smart thinking. But it's where the story tips, isn't it? That it's still in there, understanding and knowing what God is going to do and allowing God to play his part in it, I think, is one of the keys.
Yeah. So when we're thinking about it's something else, there is that part of it, which is exploration.
Totally.
And I think the whole
like
thing
that.
Of creativity, of us being where God wants us right now, is that, you know, I think God is asking us to explore some new things.
Mm.
to explore the promised land, if you like.
Yeah.
And so we've got to go there, but you've got to go there to actually find out what God has for us. So that whole thing of exploration, of moving from where we are to where we can be, is really important. And then in verse 23, it tells us that what they saw there was more than they imagined.
Yeah, wow.
And I love that.
Yeah, that's
because
cool. Because it's something else.
It's something else. It's something else. But isn't that God?
Yeah.
You know, that he always brings to us something more than what we imagine.
It was even more than they had even hoped for.
Yeah. That's right.
That was their something else. And I guess that is our something else too.
Exactly.
If we choose to pray that way, believe that way. That the something else for our lives doesn't have to be things that we bump into that bring destruction to our lives, bring negativity to our lives, pull our lives apart. But there's something else that God has planned for us. Yeah. It's even more than we had hoped for. You know?
That's right.
Yeah. And I guess they discovered that in the story.
They did.
As they explored.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then as the story goes on, there's the whole response to what they saw.
Right.
And I think it's verse 28, it talks about that. And the fact that as they went into the land, as they came back and they brought a report, they started saying this, but the people living there are powerful.
Yeah.
And their towns are large and they're fortified. We saw giants there, the descendants of Anak.
Mm.
Not only that, but there were the Amalekites lived there, and the Jews, the Hittites, the Jebusites, all the otherites.
Yep.
Right? They lived in the hill country. The Canaanites live along the coast. And so there was all of this reporting that came back to the people, which actually turned into this negative something else.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, oh, it's something else.
Yeah.
And 10 out of the 12 who went in there brought back a bad report, even though they go into this land which has grapes the size of grapefruit, you know, and it took two guys on a pole to carry it back.
Yeah.
And then all the bounty and the fruitfulness of the land that God was going to give to them, they still come back and go, no, but there are other things there that are too big for us.
Mm. Man, I don't know if you've ever been there, right? Promise on the other side of some mountain or some obstacle or something that seems too big. But that's where God comes into play. That's why God is who he is, because without him, we can't achieve these things. And I guess this story is just, it's just a great example, right? Of how we find, where we find ourselves and how we live our lives sometimes. Yeah. But we can obviously have the story in hindsight. And so to take that story and go, no, we want to be the group of people that trusts in the promise of God, because the promise of God is the promised land. It's a space where we can enter into and be all that God has called us to be.
Right.
The interesting thing about the 10 that brought the negative report, some of their feelings were that if we enter into this promised land with all this good stuff, we might lose our spirituality,
right?
Because it's material goods that we're now looking at. Like God is, even though God has said, "I'm providing the space for you," they were coming at it with a tradition and a mindset that said, if we enter into this place, the people might become materialistic.
Right.
And therefore we need to hold back the people from this promise. Because I don't know if we can handle it.
Right.
And I guess that comes way back from being in slavery, what they knew. But isn't it important for us to move into the new and allow God to lead us into those spaces?
Right.
Because it became a negative thing for their lives. And I guess the thing was, it was actually God had set that place up because it's actually about us moving into creation. God calls us into creation to help take creation and set up a new place for God to dwell.
Right.
And that's what God had really called them to do, take what was in the promised land, reshape it, work it into something beautiful for then God to come and be with them and dwell with them in that place. Right. Yeah. But they didn't realize that. Yeah. The 10 didn't realize that and somehow thought, I don't know how. In fact, let's keep the people back from this place. Right. We shouldn't enter in there. Therefore, sent a negative report through the people, which they then believed.
Yeah.
And what's interesting to note is actually in the Torah, in the Hebrew, that word, you know, it translates to us, or we read it as spies, But in actually the original, in the original text, the word can actually translate as traitors and deserters.
Whoa.
So the spies that went in, the 10, they became traitors. They were traitors toward God because God had promised this thing.
Yeah.
And they turned their back on God and said, no, no, no. And actually sent that report through the people. And so the people then turned their back on the promise too and said, no, this isn't what we're going to do. And then what happened to them? They ended up being deserters.
Yep.
They ended up spending 40 years in the desert place.
Crazy.
So it's really interesting, eh? That's how that translates and reads, you know.
Yeah. And the reason we know that there were a couple of guys that didn't go with that report was that the scripture tells us that, you know, when Caleb interrupted all of this that's going on.
Wow.
He didn't join.
I love that word too, interruption.
That's right.
And sometimes we need to interrupt our inner thoughts, interrupt our own lives, or even interrupt, the in the circles of people that trust us and we trust them, to say, when negative reports are flying around the room, interrupt that moment and say, hey, look, let's stand on the word of God. What is God actually saying to us, or what has he said to us that we need to pull in, back into our present day?
Right, that's cool. So verse 30, and this is from the Message, Caleb interrupted and he called for silence.
Yeah.
And how much noise.
Wow, yeah.
How much noise is in our world.
Right.
And in our lives, and particularly at this time too. You know, even though the streets have been quieter.
Yep.
Even though the whole world's been quieter.
Yep.
There's still a lot of noise going on in people's heads and in people's lives,
trying
to work out and sort out what's going on right now.
Yeah.
And so we need to learn to be silent.
Yeah.
So that we can actually hear God speaking to us.
Mm.
And we can hear the report of, hey, come on, there is something else, which is really great for us.
Yeah.
And so let's learn to be silent so we can listen to God.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good. And let's just take a moment of silence right here, right now. Yeah. I mean, it's so true. I mean, sometimes there's that scripture that talks about be still and know, you know, and around that whole idea of being still is the sense of quietness and stillness. And I think it's something, again, that we need to practice.
Yeah, exactly.
Practice stillness, practice being silent, practice in those moments tuning in and listening to what God, what the Holy Spirit want to say to us, and what the Holy Spirit wants to lead us into. And what we're saying today and what we're suggesting today is that he wants to lead us into something else. And that something else, even though up front it may look like there's giants, it may look like there's whatever, but the promises of God are his promises, and he has got good things. Even with speaking into the life of Majestic today, you know, we're in this building today. The promises of God are true. What he wants to in and work through our lives as a community, as a church, is beautiful things. He wants to do a work in us and through us that is going to excite us on the daily, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And we have vision for this city and beyond. And God wants to, he wants to see his people come to him, and he wants to outwork that through us, through his church. And so his promises are real. His promises for your life, his promises for your family, what he says in his word. Can I encourage you today, stand on that again, pray into that again, believe again, don't give up now, keep going. And in that, God wants to also, within that journey, reveal things to us that are going to be important for our lives, that are going to be character building for our lives. And I think this was the opportunity that was presented to the people. They now had a moment to make a choice, but because of a negative report that outweighed the positive report, they turned. In fact, you know, in some of the story, right, they were threatening to actually do something about the guys, like stone them, kill them, let's get rid of them. We don't want to hear that. We don't want to hear about the good stuff. And sometimes in our lives, we sort of begin to cut off the good stuff.
Right.
Because we're so comfortable in the pain, we're so comfortable in the maybe the negativity of our lives. But can we push back those things today, reach out for God, reach out for the good, and begin to believe again in his promises for our lives?
Yeah, absolutely.
And that comes out of maybe starting just to settle our spirits and to be still, to be silent, you know.
That's in between the coughing.
That's it.
Yeah. And the interesting thing is, like, God's promise was for all the people.
Yeah, yeah.
But because
nice.
They believed, nice. Most of them believed the bad report.
Yeah.
They said, well, it's nothingness for you.
Right.
Like a wilderness place for you.
Mm.
But he said that Scripture tells us that Caleb and Joshua, they had a different attitude. Or they
right.
had a different spirit.
Yeah.
And it was the different spirit and the different attitude.
Yeah.
Because when you think about attitude starts in the mind first.
Yeah.
They had a different attitude of the mind, and they had a different heart and a different spirit, which actually carried them.
Yes.
And God gives them the promise and saying, you guys
yeah.
are going to get the something else.
Yeah.
There is something else for you. Now, there was something else for the rest of the people
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
But it was wilderness for 40 yeah. years while a whole generation of people died off. But for Caleb and Joshua, mate, this is something, I've got this something else for you. And that's where we need to be. We need to be people who have a different attitude
yeah.
and a different spirit.
Yes.
At this time,
yes.
when all that's been going on with the good. COVID thing, and you know, there's real stuff happening for people that's
yes.
really negative, right?
Right, yeah.
And really difficult. But we've got to make sure that our attitude remains, God, you've got something for me.
Yep.
We've got to remain with a different spirit and saying, yeah. there is still a promise land
totally.
For me. There's so much more.
Yeah.
You know, we're not there yet.
Yeah.
We're not through that yet.
Yeah. But it's there.
It's there.
And it's that attitude, right? It's that spirit. And it's available. It's available for us. And I guess it's sometimes the spirit of the world, I guess. The attitude of the world can creep in to our lives. And so it's saying we want to let go of that attitude and allow that different spirit, because it's talking about a different spirit. And sometimes we can be like, oh, what's the different spirit? You know, but if you're living in Jesus, we carry that different
That's
spirit.
Right.
But it's only when we allow the spirit of other things, and there is an attitude in the world today, right now, there's an attitude, there's a spirit. And so what yep. the text is telling us today, don't be of that spirit.
Right.
Don't live in that negativity, or that I got to get what's mine, or that whatever the world is pushing
yeah.
pushing on us.
Yeah.
But because we actually live in a different kingdom.
That's right. That's it.
And there's a kingdom attitude, and there's a kingdom spirit, so to speak, that we need to live in. And that doesn't disconnect us actually from
no.
the world or from people or from relationship, but it actually empowers us to actually go into all the world,
right.
which Jesus teaches us.
Yeah.
But it does take a moment, and maybe it starts with that moment of silence. It starts with silencing some things in our lives. It starts with interrupting some things in our lives. It starts with that exploration that we've been talking about. It starts with all those things to bring us to a place where we now are open and willing and ready to again receive the power of the Holy Spirit for our lives in this time. And we know, we understand and know, and we talk about this all the time, that the Spirit of God is within us, and we have to be aware of Him in us. And yeah. You know, that scripture that talks about stir up the gift that is within you.
Yeah.
But at the same time, we also realize that the Holy Spirit is wanting to do something kind of new and fresh in us for the season.
Yeah.
To take us from where we are into where we need to go. And so maybe for you today, maybe that's a moment that you need to take for yourself and say, you know, Holy Spirit, I haven't actually asked or spoken to you for a minute, and today I need to receive you again. I need to listen to you again so that you can take me from where I am into where I need to be, because I need to develop that different spirit. I want to have that spirit of Caleb and Joshua
yeah.
that says we can take the promised land.
Oh, that's so you know? Good.
Yeah.
That's so good. And I guess what you're thinking of it practically and example-wise,
yeah.
you think about here we are in this space this morning is, you know, the whole thing of now there's something else.
Mm.
And this is like the beginning of an exploration for us
yeah.
as a church.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we've got together all the gear so we're able to do this.
Yeah.
And this is a whole new thing. This is
yeah.
a whole new exploration of
right.
something that we are now going to have to develop and it's going to have to become a part of our world.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
what we do on an ongoing basis,
mm-hmm.
but it's about taking those opportunities.
Yeah.
So, man, there is something else, and there's something else that, even in this. You know,
it's
all come out of a bad situation, but this is going to be powerful.
Yeah,
the fact that we can be online is going to be powerful. It's going to grow. It's going to be something that people who tune in and listen to, who may never walk initially inside a church building, are going to find God because of it. And I think that's really amazing. You know, yeah, I think that's, for me, that's the biggest opportune takeaway for this time as far as the world is concerned and people in our communities are concerned, that they're able to do and tune in to what we're doing today.
Yeah, that's it. And we wouldn't have necessarily found ourselves here or been here if it wasn't for what would seem to be a negative thing that's happening around the world, right? And something that could be that is putting fear in people, something that is restricting people. But out of those restrictions, out of those fears, when you can rise above that, we talked about faith a few weeks ago. Put those things into play. Perspective is everything.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then acting out on that.
Yeah.
Not just saying, oh, there could be a different perspective here. Yeah. Oh, you know, imagine if we not. But then let's begin to action those things. Yeah. Action those things out. And sometimes that's also about speaking out the good things.
Yeah.
And sometimes it starts there too. You know, like Caleb and Joshua, they actually spoke out a good report.
That's right.
They said, you got to see the fruit. You got to see what's there. And they didn't just say that. And they said, we can take this place.
Yeah, we can do it.
We can actually do it. And today you can do it. Yeah. Today you can take it. Today you can be it because you have the power of Jesus on the inside of you. You know, if you've committed your ways to Him, and maybe you find yourself this morning and you've been away from God or you've been disconnected from Him, you can take a moment today to even just say, come back to love, come back to life.
Yeah.
Come back to Him and say, Jesus, I need you again in my world. Yeah. Because when He becomes the center of your world, He becomes the strength of your life. You can wake up tomorrow realizing that you can have purpose and you can live a life in and through love. And beyond that, that there is literally a power, a spirit that can be within you and cause you to create and speak out life that you can then walk into and help others to get there as well. So this whole new world is creating opportunities for us. And I love what you were saying, Dad, because we're beginning to kind of speak into vision there and begin to kind of speak prophetically about the people who can be connected to this place through what we're doing right now and through the physical doors of this place. And we're believing for this city, like other churches in our city. We're believing for people to find home, for people to find purpose.
Yep.
And as we continue to do what we're doing, and as God continues to lead us, we believe so many people are going to find that in this era and in this time. And then I think it's about, you know, we've been talking about this a little bit. It's about having those conversations and to keep talking, because things do start there in terms of a conversation. Right. Because it's, like we said earlier, it's real for people's lives. You know, there's real stuff happening. And this morning you can kind of take a word like this and say, well, that's all nice and that's in the Bible and hey, yeah. But we understand that it's real, but we also understand that the power of God is even more real.
Come on.
That is what's real.
Come on.
Our journey from here into whatever's next in life is more real than anything that we actually, you know.
Right.
And it's about God coming in and making this even more real than what it's ever been. And if the best days are ahead of us, and if we can believe that, we can believe that God wants to gather His people together. And that even, I see the beautiful thing is, when we can't do it and when our minds can't do it, God has to step in. And right now across the world, God has to step in. And so, but what that takes is for us to allow God to step into our worlds. So allow God to step into your situation today. Allow Him to move in. Because what He's opening up for us is a place for us to move in with Him. Isn't it interesting that they went into the promised land to rework it, to reshape it, to set up a place for then God to dwell with them? You know, sometimes we're waiting back on, you know, God to sort of create something for us to move into.
Right.
But it's already there.
It's already there.
Move in, and God then moves in on your life. You do, God does. You do, God does. He's at work with us, and He's at work within you. And so it's just about realizing those seasons, I guess, realizing those ebbs and flows of life, and understanding that God is constantly at work. He's constantly in love with you and what you're about. And I think if we can receive that today, allow that to power us today, you know, because like we're saying, it's something else. It's even more than what they had hoped for. And what God has for us is even more than what we are hoping for. But I hope we can believe that today. Stretch our minds today to believe that.
That's cool. we've got a final scripture. We want to share with you today.
We can.
This really, I think, wraps it up really nicely. It's from Ephesians. What is it? Ephesians 3:20, I think it is. Do you want to talk about that?
Ephesians 3:20 could be familiar to a lot of us, but we think it's powerful. So let's just read it today. God, can do anything. I mean, that right there. God can do anything. You know, allow that to, like, God, you can do anything. God, you want to do the anything in my life. God, you want to do your anything and everything through your church. God, you can do anything. You know far more than you could, and do far more than you could ever imagine or guess or request. God wants to do far more than you can ever imagine. You can, you know, the guesswork, even now we're in a season of guessing, right? Every day we're like, I wonder what New Zealand's going to, wonder what the government's going to do. We're guessing. Well, this is going to happen next and that's going to happen next. God, what are you going to do next? We can't guess it, but God can do anything. And if we believe that God is a good father, he's going to do good things for us beyond what we can imagine, what we can guess, or what we can request. Far more than what we can request.
So crazy.
So whatever you're believing for and requesting for and asking of God, God can do far more than that. That is the kind of God he is. And I think it's about us trusting in him that he is that. Trusting God that he is that. And so far more than we can request in your wildest dreams.
Yeah.
I mean, that there, right? I mean, what a scripture.
That's wild.
It's like, really? Far more?
Far more.
Than what I can even say, because I'm saying some pretty big things and I'm wanting some pretty big stuff and I'm believing for some pretty cool things, and God says far more than your wildest dreams. I feel like if we can really, I mean, even if we just spent our lives believing and working on the scripture and letting it outwork through our lives, the world would just begin to change.
Yeah.
The rest of it there is hard to read on the screen.
I do that next bit.
Go on, you do that. I can't read it.
He does it, not by pushing us around.
There you go.
But by working within us.
Yes.
His spirit deeply and gently within us. So it's a spirit work, you know. And we can get to the point where the even more than we can imagine, guess, request, our wildest dreams, knowing that God is working within us to do that, to change who we are, to bring us to a place where we can go, man, this is it, here it is.
Yeah.
It's something else.
Yeah, and the interesting thing is it's how he works in us.
Yep.
He's not pushing us around.
That's right.
It's not that idea of let me rough you up, let me toughen you up. Let me shake you around a little bit to kind of like, shake you into it's he's working gently. He's taking
deep,
time.
Deep and gentle.
Yeah. You know, it's like when you dig a well, you just don't get that done in 5 minutes. So we have to have an understanding around that deep takes time. But time is actually good, because if he gave us everything all at once, it could be just, you know, too overwhelming. So he does a time work, which is a deep work and a gentle work. And so I think even in that, in our erratic sometimes lives, in our busy lives where it's rush, 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 again, coming back to that, those moments of interruption and silence, this scripture kind of ties in with that nicely, because the work that God wants to do in our lives is actually more gentle than push us around.
Yeah, that's right.
And I think if we actually sit back and allow that to work in our lives, because I think we live in a time where we think we've got to push this and we've got to push that. So God's got to push us around and push this. And if you're in the business world, we're hustling and we're pushing people and we're getting those demands and we want that thing because we're trying to get it. And all those things are great and well, and and need to happen. But at the same time, there is the work of God that we need to understand and realize is actually a gentle work.
Yeah. Good. It's good.
Yeah, that's awesome. So it's just taking a moment and allowing His Spirit, even this morning, to do and begin that work in your life.
That's good. Great.
And so I don't know, maybe we should pray right now.
Yeah, that'd be good to do.
And just believe wherever you find yourself this morning that God can meet you right there. And He's already there with you. Yeah. But meet you with this conversation. And maybe there's something that we've just shared around this word today that has been highlighted to you that you need to pick up on. Then we ask that you do that this week. Have conversations around it this week. Believe this week. Start some new internal conversations with yourself if need be. Hopefully you've taken notes this morning. Read over those things. Find those scriptures again. And we're just believing for God's best for your life.
Good.
Today, right?
Yep.
And in this week to come. So, yeah, you want to pray?
Yep. Yeah, let's pray. God, we thank you for your promises. We thank you for the land of promise.
Mm.
Where most of us probably, if not all of us, we haven't landed in there yet. But God, I pray that you would give us the response of having a different spirit, a different heart. And we know that you can do that by working gently and deeply within us. So we want to have the attitude and the spirit of Caleb and Joshua. That's what we want.
Mm.
We want to be people of a good report. We want to bring a great report. Say, yep, we're responding to you, God, saying, God, we can do this. God, I can do this. I am in the middle of all of this, but I know that you're with me. And I'm going to go and explore what you have for me and find out just what's in that land of promise. The bounty, the fullness, the greatness. Lord, I pray this morning that there would be a revelation, an eye-opening on the inside that would come to us. That would help us negotiate and navigate this time with our response being because you've worked deeply within us. Gently, deeply, that we would take that time to silence the voices in our heads, the turmoil of our hearts, and sit and listen to you. To hear what you say. To believe what you have for us. And then to begin to walk in that and declare that, knowing that what you have for us is something great. So Lord, we pray for everyone that's struggling this morning, whether it be personally, financially, family-wise, business-wise. God, I pray you'd come to every situation today and bring your life and light into those places. That as we do sit and listen to you, that we might be running around like people who don't know what we're doing, but because we've sat and listened to you, we are hearing and listening to what you're doing in us and through us, knowing that we have got to walk into the promise that you have for us. So we thank you for that today. And we ask for that today, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
So good.
Yeah, good.
It's so good.
Thank you. That was...
Just thinking about next week, we'll be back here, but we're going to be adding more to what we're doing.
Right.
And so look out for next week.
Yeah.
It's going to be greater than today.
Ooh,
so
stop it.
So we're really getting into it now that we are able to be in this place. And let's just keep praying and believing that it won't be too long we're going to be all together.
Yeah, that's it. We're looking forward to that day. Hopefully you are too. I'm sure you are. I mean, those that we get to catch up with and talk with during the week, so good. Hey, other groups and stuff that are happening this week, join in. I know for some Zoom groups this week, there's still another week of the soul talk soul that we've been doing, which has actually been such a great tool, and really enjoyed that. So continue to look out for all that stuff. Stay up to date by just staying online, and there'll be more stuff happening throughout this week and the weeks to come.
Yep.
We're working on some more things with that. And so really important that we stay connected in that way.
Yep.
Look out for each other. Look after each other.
Don't forget the Zoom groups coming up now.
Yeah.
10:30.
Yep. Grab your coffee.
Zoom groups. Coffee groups.
Hang out.
Yep.
Do all that good stuff. Yep. And but you can get outside, though.
That's true.
We can get amongst it. Go say hi to a neighbor. Do whatever you are allowed to do within the parameters of what level 2 is.
Yeah. There you go.
And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. We will be back again.
We will.
Next week, 9:45 a.m. And like we said, there'll be more to come. So it's going to be fun.
Great.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
God bless.
See you soon.